Welcome back, Tigers. Today, we'll review how to set up custom models in campaign influence for Salesforce orgs that are not using Pardot. You will learn about 5 different campaign attribution models and how to set them up. This video assumes you understand the concepts and configuration we completed in the campaign influence initial setup video. If you missed it, there's a link to this video down below. Let's hop over to Salesforce and see how to set up custom models in campaign influence. Here we are at an opportunity, and we have a contact role here, Danny Hubble, and we can see we have 5 campaign influence records. Now these are coming in from the auto association settings that we set up in a previous video. If you missed that, make sure you check it out. Link is down below. And you can see this record with 100% influence is coming in from our primary campaign source field, this right here. Now I wanna add the model name to this related list, because when we start creating custom models, we wanna know which model is showing in this list. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to update this related list to add that field. Come to the gear icon, and then we're going to look for a field called model name. You can see I have a couple of model names here. It's because I have a formula field that we're going to be using in a flow later. So I'll add model name, I'll click save, and then we should be able to come to our list and see the model name. So we can see this is coming from our primary campaign source model. If I come back over to here and I go to my campaign influence settings, I'm gonna go to model settings, and I can see that here is my model that I have automatically. So the primary campaign source model is automatically set up by default. It is automatically marked as your default model, and then you can create new attribution models from this tab right here. Now, Salesforce does limit the number of custom models you can create, and it's dependent on what type of Salesforce edition you have and whether or not you're using Pardot. We are in an enterprise org, so we get 3 custom models that we can work with, and we're gonna click here and we're going to create a new custom model called First Touch. Now, if you check this default model checkbox, this is going to make this the default model within Salesforce. So it's going to remove the default model checkbox from the primary campaign source model. And then what's going to happen is only the records from the default model are going to show in this related list on your opportunity and campaign page layouts. So let's show you how that works. I'm going to check this as the default. I'm going to make it active. If I check locked, that means that users will not be able to create records from the campaign influence related list. It means you can only create campaign influence records using Apex or Flow. I'm going to leave this set to all records down here, and I'll click save. Now, since this is the default model, if I go look at my list, I can see that my primary campaign source model is no longer marked as default. And if I come over here, I can see that my records have disappeared. I no longer see my primary campaign source influence records. If I edit this and I check this as the default model, it unchecks it on my First Touch model, and then I'll see my records will come back. Now I'm going to make First Touch the default model. I'm going to uncheck locked. I'll click save. And then if we come back to our campaign influence list, we should be able to see a new button here. So let's refresh this. And I can see a new button right here. And I can create a campaign influence record from my related list. Now, you probably don't want to have your users doing this. That's up to you, but it is an option if you don't want to configure Apex or Flow to automatically create these records for you. If I set this back to have locked as checked, and then I come back, I'll see that my new button disappears and these records can only be created via the API. Now, one other thing I want to make sure you're aware of is whichever model is the default model, that is going to be totaled here. Those records will be totaled here in the campaign statistics section. So if your primary campaign source model is default, then the opportunities in those campaign influence records will contribute to these statistics on this campaign page. Now let's talk about the different types of campaign attribution models you can set up. Before you can figure out what kind of flows you need, you have to determine what types of models you want to set up to support your campaign influence. Now, we highly recommend that you set up more than one model because more information is always better. And there's a lot of different ways you can look at campaign attribution. And I really don't think one is better than the other. I think it's important to look at all of them. Now, in a first touch campaign attribution model, it's going to give credit to the first campaign that a contact is associated with. So in a future video, we're going to learn how to create a flow that looks at all of the campaigns that are associated with a contact on an opportunity and create a campaign influence record for the first campaign that that contact was associated with. Now, another type of campaign attribution model you can set up is called a last touch model. Now, this is similar to the first touch in that it's going to attribute all the revenue to one campaign, except it's going to be the most recent campaign that a contact is associated with. Now, a third attribution model we can set up is called an even distribution model. These models are going to give equal revenue share to all of the campaigns that a contact is associated with. So here we have our first touch, last touch, even distribution, and our primary campaign source models. Now, there is nothing creating records for the first touch, last touch, or even distribution. We're going to learn how to create a flow that's going to automatically create records for each of these types of models based on certain criteria that we configure. Now, there are a lot of arguments about which attribution model is better because there's pros and cons to all of these, right? So for your first touch and last touch models, only one campaign gets all the credit, and it might be the wrong campaign because the first campaign isn't necessarily always the most influential campaign. So your reporting may not be accurate. In an even distribution model, we can see all of the influence from all the campaigns, but maybe all of them didn't influence the opportunity evenly. So we're also going to look into a weighted distribution model in a future video too. But we'll start with first touch, last touch, and even distribution. That's it. Those are the basics for setting up the custom models. That's it. That's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on. We will show you how to create a flow that automatically creates campaign influence records for your first touch campaign attribution custom model. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.